Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's video we are going to see how basically we can read the raw files, or you can say the source files, and how basically we can perform some operations, or you can say perform some quality checks, right? So to check if the source file is having the correct data or not, right? So basically we are going to validate the source files today, and it will be like the first layer of ETL. So you can say it's an extraction layer where we are just extracting the raw data or the source data from the customer, and before dumping into the branch layer, right, we are just wanted to validate the data so that if the data validation is fine, maybe we can proceed ahead and move the data to the branch layer. So let's quickly see. And for this particular video, I'm just taking a reference of CSV file. Okay, I have one CSV file where I did some tweaks, and I have made some mistakes deliberately so that we can perform some checks on that. So here we are going to read first one CSV file. So I'm using Spark Reader. Okay. So Spark read format CSV file with the option header is equal to true, and we can load the file. Here we need to pass the file path. So I already have my file here in the DBFS. Let me see where exactly I've kept that file. Okay, yeah, it is here, and this is the file. So I'll copy the path. Since I'm working with the Spark, I will copy Spark API format. Okay, and I'll paste that path over here. Now this code will give me a data frame. Let's say this is my source data. Okay, and I wanted to print this data as well to see what kind of data we have. So I'll run this. True is not defined because T should be in capital letters. Okay. So if you see here, this is the data file I have, where I have 24 records, and I deliberately kept some null values. I kept, if you see in the salary, I have kept some text, right? So I wanted to filter this data, and in the end, I wanted to filter the correct records only, right? I don't want incorrect values. Okay, so we'll start with our first check. In this video, we will see how we can find the null values from the column. Okay, so basically I wanted to check in which column we have null values, and if there is any null values, we can filter it out. So that's what we are going to do now. So to check the filter values, what I will do, I'll quickly show you for a single column first of all. So we'll take source data format dot. We have one function filter. Okay. And in this one, I will say filter the column. Let's say registration number. Okay. If it is null. Sorry. Okay. And I will store this data frame. Let's say this is my data frame with the bad records or something. Okay, and then I wanted to display it. So if I run this one, column is not defined. So call is a basically a, you can say it's a it's a library which we need to import. Okay, it's a function basically. So we will import it by Spark dot SQL dot function import call. So if I run this now, it should work, and it will give me all the records for the registration in case, I mean, taking the registration column in consideration, and it will filter me the records which have null values, right? But if you see here in other columns also, let's say salary, right, in the salary column also we have null values. Now, I wanted to run my program or run my code for all the columns. Okay, so I'll create one more column here, and I meant to say one more cell here, and I will get the list of columns present in this particular, you can say, data frame. Okay, so to get the column, basically we have one function. Okay, so the function is source underscore df dot. There is one function columns. Okay, so it will give you a list of columns. Okay, so I can store it call dot call underscore list, let's say. Okay, and I'll print it to show you guys. So it will give you the list of columns present in a data frame. Now we have the list. If you wanted to check if it is really a list or not, you can put use function type. So type function will tell you like what kind of data you have this particular variable is holding. So this is holding a list class values. Okay, now we, since we have a list, we can simply do, we can simply use for loop, right? So we can use for name in source.columns, and then and then instead of a hard-coded value, I'll replace it with all column names where we are checking and we are just printing the bad records. If I run this, my bad, let's run it now. Yeah, so it will keep on checking for each and every cell, each and every column. So if you see, first column it checked employee, then registration. Then for other two columns, it did not find any null values, maybe name or last name. And then for sex, it found one null value. And then the next one is salary, it found null values. So in the same way, it checked for all the columns, right? And it found for these four columns, we are getting null values. Now, you really don't want to go ahead with this null values, right? So you can filter it out if it this way. But what about the columns which don't have null values, or what about the records which don't have null values, right? Because you want those records to be copied in your branch layer, right? So instead of is null, right, instead of is null, what you can do, you can use one more function called is not null. Okay, so let's quickly see how to use that function also. Okay, I'll copy this statement entirely. I'll use one more cell here, paste it here, and say is not null function, and I'll run it. Instead of bad record, I will say it's a data frame, actual data frame, and I'll print it. Okay, let's see, it is running, and now it is giving me all the records, right? So, but generally we don't perform these null checks for all the columns. Yeah, we generally check null values for primary keys or some specific column where customer wants the data, or the data should be there, because there are certain columns where there are times there is no data and which is expected, right? So generally we don't perform this null operation for all the columns. We generally perform for few columns. Okay, so if you want to perform on few columns, maybe you can create a list of those columns and you can just pass it over here, right? So in this way, you can basically check the null values, and you can filter out your data based on null and not null values, and you can proceed ahead. So thank you for this video. In the next video, we will go ahead with another check, maybe the duplicate count or something else. Yeah, so thank you. Thanks a lot.